One of the really exciting ways to experience your study site is to really see it, and to see all the tracks and wildlife sign that are left behind by the animals that visit your habitat. Incidental observations are just a fancy way of saying, I looked, and I saw, and this is what I saw. And in looking, you get a much better picture of what's going on in your environment. So what you're looking for is evidence of wildlife activity, whether it's their tracks, or rubs on trees, or even the scat that they leave behind. So the first step in making your incidental observations is to determine your search path. You're going to want to be able to repeat it every time you go out on your observations, so be sure it's something that you can follow, like a trail, or a road, or a waterway. Oh, this looks different. Look, see how the bark is peeled away a little bit and there's a smooth area right here? Bark doesn't normally grow quite like this, does it? This looks an awful lot like a deer antler rub. Down by the river, there's a really good chance you'll see lots of different wildlife tracks. Here I found a little deer track and two little raccoon tracks. They look like little baby hands right here. This looks like raccoon scat. Make note of the location, and if I have a camera, I'll take a picture of it, and then I'll move on. What's really exciting about doing your incidental observations is that as you do it, you get better and better at really seeing what's going on in your environment. It'll also allow you to see deeper and make discoveries about the connections within your habitat.